Goshen Middle School. I'm Thomas and I'm your host for GMTV. No, I do not have a dumb Instagram name. Now let's send it over to Ellie and Maddie with the news.
Good afternoon, GMS. I'm Alicia, also known as Allie.
And I'm Miss Maddie, and this is your GMS news.
Thank you for all who participated in Red Ribbon Week.
Congratulations to Cade Fisher, who is the new National Junior Honor Society President, Raina Shana Barger, who is the new Vice President, Jill Kissinger, the Secretary, Matthew Herman, and Philip Burtz, who are the new Co-Treasurers.
The GHS Music Department will be sponsoring Miles for Music on Saturday, November 9th at the Elkhart County 4-H Fairgrounds. The fun starts at 9 a.m. The cost is $25 on a day of event. There will be a free t-shirt for the first 100 people who check in on Saturday the 9th.
There will be trophies for the top male and female runners, drawing for prizes and free pancakes to runners and walkers. Entry forms are available for any GHS band, orchestra, or choir student.
Today after school will be the fundraiser mega party from 3:45 to 5 p.m.
Don't forget, the end of first trimester is November 6th.
The GMS and GHS Music Departments would like to announce the beginning of their annual fall fruit sale at Kircher Sunrise Orchard. The sale will run from Monday, October 28th through Friday, November 15th. Prices range from $19 to $33, depending on the size of the box or basket ordered. Items available include oranges, grapefruit, and apples sold separately and mixed. Stop by Kircher's Orchard and support GCS Music.
This has been your GMTV for Friday, November 1st.
Have a great weekend, GMS.
I wasn't. Okay, let's get started. So, my name is Megan Weather with your Jason News. Never mind. So, as you see, this afternoon it'll be partly cloudy with a high of 57 and a low of 39 in degrees. Y el tiempo para mañana va a ser pocas lluvias, so get your umbrella and raincoat. The high of 48 and a low of 32 in degrees. And finally, it will clear up a little and be like today with partly cloudy with a high of 52 and a low of 33 in degrees. So that's your Jason, and this has been me, Weather, with your Bear Honda News.
Oh, honey, bro, it's okay. I'm sorry.
Hello GMS, I'm Rudy with the Clubs and Meetings. Ski Club will travel to Swiss Valley on Tuesday evenings from 4 to 10 p.m. Forms and payments are due this Friday, no later than 3:30. The cost if you need your own equipment is $157, and if you need to rent skis or a snowboard, it's $199. Builders Club will be meeting on Friday, November 5th in room 205. S Club will be on November 6th at 3:45. Students' Council will be meeting Thursday, November 7th in the Administrative Room.
Haley, you're tardy again.
Sorry, Mrs. Carbonoff.
Be more than sorry.
Good afternoon, GMS. I'm Mr. Whitaker.
And I'm Mr. Alphen.
And this is This Week in History.
This week.
Let's get started with the history for this week. This happens to be the week of Halloween, by the way. Halloween's like my second favorite holiday. Mostly because when I was a little kid, my dad made me a Transformers outfit out of cardboard boxes. And it was supposed to be Optimus Prime, but everybody thought I was a house. Literally. They were like, what are you? Are you a house? It looked like I had windows here because Optimus Prime had windows on his chest. It was weird. But anyways, that was back in history. So this week in 1950, a guy named Earl Lloyd actually becomes the first black player to play in the NBA. And that's interesting because we typically don't realize that before this, there were no black men who played in the NBA. And it's an interesting, interesting fact.
That's basketball, right?
I'll Google that.
So.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. All right. Well, on this day in history, or this week in history, King George III of England, I think you're all familiar with who that is, he speaks for the first time publicly after the 4th of July Declaration of Independence of our ancestors here in America, declaring independence from the king. So it took him... How many weeks is that?
I don't do math.
Quite a few weeks before he finally addresses Parliament and says, This isn't looking good.
You're right, it's not.
What is this?
Yeah. All right. Okay. So, in this week in 1926, Harry Houdini dies. If you know anything about Houdini, you know that Houdini was an escape artist. He could get away from anything, and he did it. The way he did it was so insane sometimes, we still look back on some of his escapes and can't really figure out how he did some of them. The interesting thing about Houdini now is that he died the week of Halloween. I believe it was actually Halloween Day.
Yes.
Which is scary.
That is weird. Very weird.
But throughout his life, he campaigned against spiritual mediums and the paranormal, and he always tried to show how they were all fakes. But then at the same time, he had this weird pact with his wife and friends that whoever was the first to die in their group would try to communicate with the rest of the group from the dead. The funny thing here is that his wife waited like 20 years after he died to finally declare this experiment a failure.
I just heard something. This is creeping me out. Did you hear that?
No, but I smell something.
Maybe that's what it was. Okay. All right. Anyhow, Sherlock Holmes is published in 1892. Okay, so, you know, there's a movie about it now. But in 1892, Sherlock Holmes is published. Interestingly enough, on Halloween. It's weird.
This whole segment.
This whole segment is weird.
Anyways.
Conan Doyle, who wrote Sherlock Holmes, he was a dedicated spiritualist. Perhaps he and Houdini are speaking to each other from the dead.
Chilling.
Just chilling.
Yeah. Well, speaking of Houdini.
Yeah.
We got this awesome video of a dog who is also an escape artist. The dog's name is Houdini. And you know how I love animals.
That's right.
So let's throw it over to the dog Houdini. And by the way, do you remember when... Remember when you and I got arrested again? And like I was trying to escape?
Yeah, and I was like, do you know who I am? I'm King George! And they didn't know
that was Halloween night.
Yeah.
And they didn't understand your costume.
They didn't get it.
Right.
I had the wig on and everything, and it was...
Anyhow, back to Houdini.
Anyway.
Houdini, you bad girl.
That's all for this week, GMS. Thanks for watching.
Happy Halloween.
Beam Pop Featured Movie is a Beam Pop on the go, where you have access to more than 750 videos by Moby and Tim. If you like road trip games or racing games, then Extreme Road Trip 2 is the game for you because there's huge gratifying explosions in every stage, and you can unlock more than 78 cars while quickly going through obstacles and survive as hard as you can to get all the achievements you can. Minecraft Pocket Edition is like the beta version of Minecraft. There's not that many blocks, but you still fight creepers, zombies, skeletons, and spiders, and mine for diamonds and survive through the night.
Sometimes a shadow wins. if you say what you wanna say.
Times six.
5 times 6 is
30.
What is 5 times 6?
I have no idea.
What's 5 times 6?
30.
30. Who founded the Apple Company?
Steve Jobs.
Who founded the Apple Company?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Who founded the Apple Company?
I have no idea.
Who founded the Apple Company?
Mr. Johnny Appleseed.
How many hours are in a day?
24.
Oh. How many hours are in a day?
A lot.
How many hours are in a day?
24.
How many hours are in a day?
I still have no idea.
What shape is this?
A happy triangle.
A happy triangle. What shape is this?
It's a triangle.
What is the square root of 25?
Square root of 25? 5?
How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood?
A lot of wood.
Smarticles. How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood?
A lot.
Smarticles. How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood?
A lot of wood.
Smarticles. How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood?
I don't know. Want me to ask him?
This has been your GMTV for November 1st. Stay classy, San Diego.